Hello and welcome to the video about Trump Excel. I'm Sumit Bansal, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to round numbers to the nearest integer or to the nearest multiple of 0.5 or 5 or 10. Now, here is a simple data set where let's suppose you are a project manager and you have these 5 projects and you do effort estimation and you come up with these number of hours that it'll take for you or your team to complete these projects. And the client has given you these many days. So based on this, you calculate the total number of full-time equivalents or the total number of resources needed for each project. So it's a simple calculation where I have divided this number by 3 into 8 because I'm considering an 8-hour workday. So I have these numbers, but the problem here is that I cannot really allocate 6.71 resource or 6.71 employees on a project. I need to allocate 7. Similarly, here I need to allocate 6 people. So what I need to do is I need to round these numbers to the next integer. Now, there are a couple of functions to do this. And if you're thinking about the int function, int function, it would work, but the problem with this function is that it would simply truncate the decimal part and give you the integer portion of this. So for example, if I do this, then it will simply truncate the decimal part, but this is not what I want. I want the next integer value. So in this case, what I would have to use is the round up function. So round up function takes 2 arguments. The first one is the number, which would be this in this case. And the second one is the number of digits. And in this case, I want this to be rounded up to 0 number of digits, which means that I do not want any decimal portion. I only want the integer and I want this to get rounded up. So if I enter 0 here and I hit enter, you can see I get 7 here. And if I copy it for all these cells, I get the correct value. I get 7 here, 6, 8, 8, and 12. So this is how you can round to the nearest integer or round up to the nearest integer. If you only want to round to the nearest integer, let's say for example, if it's okay, if it's 7.29 and you can get away with allocating only 7 resources on this, then you can use the MROUND function. And MROUND function would round to the nearest based on whether it's rounding up or rounding down based on the closest integer or the closest number of the multiple that you specify. So in this case, since the number is this, I would use D2 and the multiple here would be 1. And now when I hit enter, see what happens? This becomes 7, this becomes 6. But in this case, there is a difference because this is 7.29, which is closer to 7. But in this case, 7.58 is closer to 8. So MROUND would round to the nearest integer or the nearest multiple that you specify. Similarly, let's see another example here. I have the same data set. And in this case, what we can do is instead of rounding it up to the nearest integer, as a project manager, you may think that you'll make an employee work for half a day. So what you can do is you can round this to the nearest multiple of 0.5. And to do that, we'll simply use the MROUND function as I showed you a couple of seconds ago. So this would be the number and the multiple here would be 0.5. And let's see what happens. If I use this, it'll give me all these numbers, which will round it up to the closest multiple of 0.5. But in case you only want to round it up, then you can use the ceiling function. So the ceiling function is this one. You have 2 functions here, ceiling.math and ceiling. They both do the same thing. It's just that this one is the old function where you see this yellow triangle. And this one is the new one. So if you're seeing the ceiling.math function, do use this one. And in this case, the first would be the number. The first argument would be the number, which is this. And then it'll ask for the significance value. And in this case, the significance value would be 0.5. And now when I hit enter, you can see it'll give me 7 and it'll give me 5.5. But here is the difference. MROUND would give me the closest multiple number, which would be 7.5. But since I'm using the ceiling function, which would it would round it up to the closest multiple of 0.5, which is 8. So you can see you can do ceiling.math. Similarly, if you wanted to round it down, then you can use floor.math. So here it's floor.math. OK, Okay, let me type this again. Flow.math, and here's the number and the significance is 0.5. So in this case, it'll round these numbers down to the nearest multiple of 0.5. So not the nearest multiple, the lower multiple of 0.5. So you can use MROUND, you can use ceiling, or you can use floor depending on what you want to get done. Now, it's a very simple example. Now, if you want to round these to the nearest 5, you can simply use MROUND. This is the number, the multiple is 5. And let's see what it gives us. It gives us these results because these are closest to those numbers. 161 is closest to 160. Let's see what happens when I change this to 163. It gives me 165 because now 163 is closer to 165. The difference is only 2. If you want to always round these up, then you can use the ceiling method. Again, let me quickly show it to you. Ceiling math, this is the number and the significance is 5. And you can see there is a difference here because in 132, if you use MROUND, it'll give you 130 because that's the nearest multiple of 5. But in ceiling, it'll always take this number to the next number, which is a multiple of 5. Similarly, if you want to go down, you can use floor math. Floor math, this is the number, significance is 5. And it'll give you the number, the multiple, which is the lower one, which is lower than this number. And similarly, in case of nearest 10, you can use two kinds of formula. So let me first quickly show you MROUND. MROUND, as we all know, would do it to the nearest one. So in this case, the multiple would be 10. So this is the result of MROUND. Let me type MROUND here. Now, again, we can use ceiling or floor. So let's quickly see the results of ceiling and floor, and I'll show you a new formula or a new way of doing this. So let's quickly use ceiling math. This is the number, the significance is 10, so it'll give us the next multiple, and in this case it'll give us the previous multiple or the lower number. So here it would be 10. Now, another way, in case you want to round to the nearest 10 or nearest 100, another way of doing it is using the round up or round down function. So let me quickly show you how these work. In case of round up, this is my number, but if I want it to get round up by the multiple of 10, then I can use minus 1. So 0 is when it's not a multiple, when there is no multiple in case of round up. But if I use minus 1, it'll go one step back and it'll consider it as 160. So it'll be a multiple of 10. So see what happens? It'll give me 170, which would be the same result as ceiling in this case. And similarly, I can also use a round down. So if I come here, round down, and I can again use the same thing, minus 1. And minus 1 would give me the multiples of 10. If I make it minus 2, it'll give me the multiples of 100. Minus 3 would give me the multiples of 1000. So you can also use a roundup or you can use ceiling. I recommend you use ceiling because this function is typically made for this. So there are three ways of doing it. You can either use MROUND, ceiling or floor, and then there is roundup, round down, which would work only in the case when you are rounding it off to the nearest 10 or nearest 100 or nearest 1000. So these are the ways to round numbers to the nearest integer or to the nearest multiple in Excel. That's it in this video. I hope you found this useful. Thank you and have a nice day.